अच्छा, सो इन ए नटशेल एंटायर जनरेशन ऑफ द सोलर पावर प्लांट इज एक्सप्लेन्ड इन दिस स्मॉल फ्लो डायग्राम और ए डायग्राम वेयर द फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज द सोलर पैनल अरे, एमरजेंसी जनरेटर, चार्ज कंट्रोलर, इन्वर्टर, बैटरी बैकअप एंड देन पैनल बॉक्स एंड फ्रॉम देयर वी हैव आवर एप्लीकेशंस. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द लोड्स. ओके, वेयर वी कैन पुट लोड ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर पावर जनरेशन सिस्टम और द पावर जनरेशन सिस्टम इज यूज टू सप्लाई दिस मेनी अमाउंट्स ऑफ पावर टू ड्राइव दिस काइंड ऑफ equipments which are there in your house. So as I said in the earlier classes, the first important thing is you should try to have a list of all the electrically driven machineries and substances in your house, right from your televisions, your laptops, number of cell phones, power banks, printers, anything whichever are derived by means which are running on the basis of electric current. Even for a matter of fact, you can consider your submersible pump, you can consider your refrigerator, air conditioner, everything you put it. And then what is the amount of time you are going to run them? That is also very important, because we have to estimate how much amount of energy which we are supposed to send to your system. So how many hours we are going to use this electronic gadgets or this current consumers is a very important thing. So once you are having a clear picture of these kind of requirements, then we will go for the designing of a system which can provide this much amount of energy for your house. So here the basic parts of the solar power plant system is the solar panel. That is very important. So solar panel, as I said, it is a discovery of this decade, because it does a miraculous job without consuming anything. The only thing is the sunlight will be falling on it and then it will be producing electrons. Electrons are nothing but flow of electrons is current, electric current. If anybody asks you what is current, you should say flow of electrons is called as current. Like that, this panel will be taking the sunlight and then the electrons will be sent out from the system. So this solar panel is of three types. The first one is monocrystalline, which is having only one type of crystal. Crystal means what you can imagine, sugar. Sugar is a form of a crystal, made up of sugar material. So the first form of the solar panel is monocrystalline, which is highly efficient and little bit of costly. Then comes the question of polycrystalline, which is less effectiveness, which is less efficient when compared to the monocrystalline. And the last one is amorphous. MRFS is the cheapest form of the cheapest concept of the solar panel. So if a solar monocrystalline solar panel is giving 15 volts and then its surface area is X, then if you go for the cheaper one to produce X, the surface area should be more. So again comes a question that to reduce the size of this, to reduce the cost of your solar panel, you can increase the size of the solar panel. I repeat once again, to reduce the cost which you are going to invest in the solar panel, you are supposed to increase the surface area, the size of the solar panel. So now the most important thing is, in your house, on your rooftop, is the space is available or not? So if you have abundant and a copious amount of space on your rooftop, then you can go for the third one, or the amorphous form of the solar panel, which is very cheap. But of course, the area, it will be a bigger one because it gives the same amount of energy which the monocrystalline is producing. And vice versa, if you don't have much amount of space on your roof, then there is no other go. You are supposed to go for monocrystalline, which is even costlier, but size is very small. So now can imagine how many parameters you are supposed to consider in designing a solar power plant for your house. Not only the load, the time, and the area which is available in your house. You can't say that I will be constructing the solar power plant on the adjacent building and then I will be deriving the current. Nobody will accept this. So you should be in a position to supply your own rooftop for the erection of this solar power generation systems, or precisely basically the solar panel. Then once you know the solar panel, then you will have what type of panel you are going to purchase it, that you have a solution now. As I said, you will be having monocrystalline, polycrystalline, and amorphous. So the efficiencies are decreasing. Monocrystalline efficiency is very high, polycrystalline is little bit reduced, amorphous is further reduced. But if you are interested in taking the same amount of voltage, then what you can do is you can increase the number of panels. That is the meaning of it. Means what? For a particular purpose, if you require two monocrystalline, then for the same purpose you may require six amorphous. As I said, when you have a space, we can go for that. If you don't have a space, you'll go for monocrystalline only. So this, after the arrangement of these solar panels on the rooftop, how you should arrange, sir? You should arrange that they will be facing the east side of your house. So both the arms will be facing south and north, whereas the panel is exposed to east, because sun rises from the east and then he sets in the west. So if he is rising from the east, initially you will have lot of the energies, lot of radiations falling on it. But as time passes, what will happen? He may cross the solar panel in the afternoon and you may not give much energies. So this is a usual, mindset people will have in their brain, that all solar panels should be focused to east side. That is terribly wrong. So you are now supposed to keep your solar panel such that the plane is on the line of north and south. So when the plane is on the north and south, what will happen? Though the sun is traveling from east to west, majority of the radiations will fall onto this solar panel. That is the orientation of the solar panel. Then once you know the energy of it, you can also predict how many solar panels you are going to purchase. And after the purchasing of solar panels, you are going to say, for example, if the voltage requirements are there, you divide the voltage requirements by single solar power panel, because each and every solar panel which is available in the market, it will be having its own different specifications. So if you are going to purchase monocrystalline also, in the monocrystalline also, they will be having variations, 12 volts, 24 volts, 36 volts. So which one you are going to take it? So this is, if you are going to go for 36 volts, of course cost will be more, but the number will be less. If you are going for 12 hours, the car you will be purchasing 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever the number of more number of solar panels, so cost will be increasing. So since you have a space, you are going for this. So it all depends upon the size of the, sorry, the size of the rooftop which you are able to give for this process. And the second one was what is the electrical appliances which are there in your house. That is the two important factors which will decide the size of the solar panels. Then, as I said, that the sunlight will fall onto the solar panel, and the photons which are present in the sunlight, they are converted to the electrons, and the electrons will be coming out from the solar fan. So now with the help of your wire, I give connection to the charge controller. And as far as possible, I say that pipe wiring, the wiring should be, length of the wiring should be very less. Means what? You are having a solar panel in first floor, in the rooftop, and in an apartment of four apartments are there, four floors are there, and you are in the ground floor with the solar panel. So you know what will happen. The cost will increase tremendously. So that is the reason why, to reduce the cost of these components, people are using the distance between the source and the generation is very, very less. They are reducing so that they can reduce the transportation losses also. Means what? If you want to have a solar power energy for your house, on your rooftop only you should have it, and now you should use lesser number of the pipe, the length of the pipes or electrical wires which you are going to use, it should be very less. Then of course the overall cost is also less, and the process will take place successfully. So once you have a solar panel erected on your rooftop, you are supposed to connect them seriously. Remember this. This is very important. Means what? Every solar panel will have a positive terminal and negative terminal. So if you bring two solar panels, the positive terminal of one panel should be connected to the negative terminal of other panel. So like that, in a serial fashion, whatever the solar panels you are going to use it, in a serial fashion, you are supposed to have it. And then keep it ready. Then comes the question of the charge controller. What will happen to the charge controller? As I said that in the summer, the sunlight will be very high. The electrical generation will be very high. So the current flow will be very high, because of which it may damage the remaining part of the machinery. So to avoid this, we try to keep a charge controller. This charge controller will be withstanding the variations of the flow of currents and ensures the other parts of the system with a constant energy flow rate. That is what is done in our charge controller. Please remember. So from the charge controller, the wires are now going to the inverter. Okay, so from the inverter, what will happen? The inverter will be stabilizing the current, and then now it will go for the charge. So charging means what? We have a battery. So as I said that you can have a storage water tank in your house, a small family, 500 liters Syntex tank is sufficient. A bigger family, 1000 liters of Syntex tank is sufficient. A very large, bigger family can have 5,000 liters of Syntex tank. But in case of an apartment, we should have a big water storage system on your rooftop, where your watchman will be pumping two times a day or three times a day, depending upon the consumption of water. So storage or the size of the battery again depends upon your question. What is the question? how many electrical appliances are there in your house, and how much amount of time you are going to run them without the lack of the conventional power supply. So based on that, we are going to design this battery backup, and from there what will happen? Yes. So what is the flow? Yes, sunlight falls onto the solar panel. Through the charge controller, it goes to the inverter. Inverter, in a stabilized manner, it will be charging the battery. Very good. Story successful. So from morning onwards, you are keeping the batteries for charging. So after the batteries are charged, what will happen? You can't change them. You can't take them to some other place. What you should do? You should immediately convert that battery. That is the power which is coming out from that. It is 12 volts, isn't it? So this 12 volts DC has to be converted to 220 volts of AC. It should be converted to 220 volts of AC. Because you know very well, all our home appliances are running on alternative current, where the voltage varies from 220 volts to 240 volts. So in this particular range, you are supposed to provide the energy for your house. That thing is taken care of by the inverter. So from there, it goes to the panel box. From the panel box, it is distributed to the entire house. But here we have an emergency generator. What is an emergency generator, sir? It is nothing but the plug which is there in your house, from where you are putting the electrical power supply from Telangana grid. So you insert it, what will happen? Whenever it is actually a backup, whenever there is a rainfall is there, or when the sunlight is not proper, not bright on that particular day, then the amount of electron generated by the solar panel will be minimum. Because of it, we may not charge our batteries so fast or up to the optimum levels. So hence immediately the demand is coming in the night. So we are not in a position to supply the electrical power. In that case, the grid, Telangana grid, from where you started charging is used. So what is the role of this inverter here? It takes the energy from the grid, 220 volts AC, convert it to DC 12 volts, and then charge the battery, because battery can be charged only by means of DC. No AC will work. Similarly, I think we are, so it will be taking AC and then it will be charging and then it will be converted to DC. So only DC power can be used for the charging of the batteries, 12 volts batteries. So this many significant operations are done by the inverter. Let us have a quick revision of what is the role of an inverter, because this is a very important bit question. So basically, it will be converting the charge. Whatever the feed is coming from the charge controller, it stabilizes and then ensures that in a 12 volts, it is going to charge the battery. And once the battery is fully charged, it will stop the charging of battery, and then the charge controller is again short-circuited. Like that, the system comes to stable state. And then whenever the demand comes, it takes the energy from 12 volts, the inverter converts it to 220 volts AC, and then it gives us the supply which we require it. And the vice versa, if you're having a generation system in your house by means of solar panel, again the same thing will take place. And apart from that, we also have a provision to charge the batteries by means of alternative method, that is by means of emergency generator, that is nothing but our grid, the plug which is there in your house, you insert the wire into it, so it takes Telangana grid power, and then that will be 220 volts, that will be converted to 12 volts DC, and this 12 volts DC is used for charging the batteries. So this is the basic operation of a solar power plant. Let us see a video.
Solar power एक free source of energy है. इस free और unlimited energy source को इस्तेमाल.
I'm sorry, the video is in Hindi. We can decode the language. There's no problem.
करके आप अपने घर का लोड चला सकते। सोलर पावर एक फ्री सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी है।
यस, इट इज अ फ्री सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी। वी आर नॉट पेइंग एनीथिंग टू सन। यस, सी वी आर सन, वी आर नॉट पेइंग एनीथिंग। सो कंटिन्यूअसली जनरेटिंग एनर्जी एंड देन वी आर यूजिंग इट। सो बिकॉज ऑफ इट वी आर गोइंग टू कॉल दिस एज ए फ्री सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी।
इस फ्री और अनलिमिटेड एनर्जी सोर्स को इस्तेमाल कर
अनलिमिटेड। यस, रिमेंबर दिस बिकॉज इट इज अ ह्यूज अमाउंट व्हिच इज कमिंग टू द अर्थ। सो फ्रॉम मॉर्निंग टू इवनिंग इट विल बी एमिटेटिंग सन। So it is in your role to harness or convert or trap the solar energy and use it for our purpose.
कि आप अपने घर
every statement is very important. Remember carefully.
का लोड चला सकते हैं और batteries भी चार्ज कर सकते हैं।
Yeah. What is the purpose of it? You can directly use electrical appliances in your house or you can store that energy in the battery.
और जो बिजली आप इन दोनों कामों के लिए यूज कर रहे थे उसे ना यूज करके आप अपने पैसे भी बचा सकते हैं।
हाउ? यस, बिकॉज टिल टुडे हाउ यू आर यूजिंग योर एनर्जी, वी आर परचेसिंग इट फ्रॉम तेलंगाना गवर्नमेंट एंड देन वी आर यूजिंग इट। बट सपोज इफ यू इंस्टॉल अ सोलर पावर प्लांट देन यू डू नॉट परचेस फ्रॉम द तेलंगाना ग्रिड, सो यू आर सेविंग योर मनी। दिस इज हाउ वी आर सपोज टू जस्टिफाई इकोनॉमिकली to the consumer, then only he will change from using electricity from Telangana grid to solar power plant.
Solar power use करने के लिए आपको अपने घर में solar power system लगाना पड़ेगा। Solar power system तीन types के होते हैं, डीसी सिस्टम, ऑन ग्रिड और ऑफ ग्रिड सोलर सिस्टम। इस वीडियो में हम डीसी सिस्टम कैसे काम करता है ये समझेंगे। डीसी सिस्टम एक ऐसा इनोवेटिव और एनवायरमेंटल फ्रेंडली होम लाइटिंग सोलर सॉल्यूशन है जो ऐसे एरियाज के लिए स्पेशली डिजाइन है जहां फ्रीक्वेंट पावर कट्स की प्रॉब्लम है या जिन एरियाज में बिजली बिल्कुल अवेलेबल नहीं है।
This can be used at a place where frequent power cuts are there and where we don't have much supply of electric power. So this is called a Telangana grid. The electrical power will come from the Telangana grid. It goes to the inverter. Inverter is charged. So suddenly when the power supply goes, what will happen? From the battery, it goes to the inverter and then this will be used to glow these things. These three things are called your load. This is LED bulb. This is the LED television monitor. And this is your fan. So these three are called as the loads. So 220 volts are converted to 12 volts and then charged in this, and 12 volts are converted to 220 volts and then they are reused back. And suppose unfortunately fan fed and sunlight is there, then instead of getting power from here, we can get power from here, no problem. So thereby what will happen, we did not pay money to the Telangana grid, remember. So you are going to save your electric bill. So this is how we are supposed to convince the consumer to purchase the solar power plants.
DC solar system जानने से पहले हमारे लिए जानना बहुत जरूरी है कि DC यानी direct current क्या होता है। Electric current दो types के होते हैं, alternating current यानी AC और direct current यानी DC। एक electric powerhouse AC produce करता है। आपके घर में पावर स्टेशन से आने वाली सप्लाई एसी होती है। घर में लगे अप्लायंस यानी टीवी, फैन, लाइट्स भी नॉर्मली एसी होते हैं। सूरज से पैदा होने वाली बिजली और बैटरी में स्टोर पावर डीसी होते हैं। आपको ये जानकर बहुत हैरानी होगी, जो एसी पावर आप अपने घर में यूज कर रहे हैं उसकी जगह अगर आप डीसी पावर सिस्टम इंस्टॉल करेंगे तो एसी पावर के मुकाबले लगभग 70% बिजली की सेविंग्स कर सकते हैं। इतना ही नहीं, जिस बैटरी से आप अपने घर में लगे एसी अप्लायंस चला रहे थे उसी बैटरी से अगर आप डीसी अप्लायंस चलाएंगे तो आपके घर में लगी बैटरी आपको तीन गुना ज्यादा बैकअप देगा। विश्वास नहीं होता पर यह बात बिल्कुल सच है। डीसी पावर
टू सी द डिफरेंस, द बैटरी व्हिच वी आर गोइंग टू यूज इन आवर हाउस इट यूज डीसी पावर सप्लाई। So if you remember all your electronic gadgets, say for example your laptop you take, though you are giving a power adapter, the entire system is driven by means of DC. So we are going to use lesser part. Why this is understood is AC means what? Alternating current. So in the alternating current, there will be a crest and trough will be there. So crest is positive, crest trough is negative. So alternatively, the cycles will be present. So we may not get full amount of the required amount of energy. But in case of DC, it is a straight line. It is a straight line. So we get continuous amount of energy. That is the difference between DC and AC.
से होने वाले फायदे और एसी पावर से होने वाले नुकसान को जानने के लिए हमें इसके वेव समझना होगा। जैसे हमने अभी समझा, एसी का मतलब है अल्टरनेटिंग करंट, यानी करंट और वोल्टेज की डायरेक्शन बदलती रहती है, यानी एसी सप्लाई की वेव फॉर्म। एक साइकिल में पॉजिटिव से नेगेटिव अल्टरनेट होती है, वहीं डीसी का मतलब है डायरेक्ट करंट, यानी करंट और वोल्टेज एक ही डायरेक्शन में फ्लो करती है। डीसी सप्लाई की वेव फॉर्म कभी नेगेटिव डायरेक्शन में फ्लो नहीं करती, जिसका मतलब है कि डीसी सप्लाई में लॉसेस काफी कम होते हैं, जिससे डीसी अप्लायंसेस एसी अप्लायंसेस के मुकाबले काफी कम पावर कंज्यूम करता है। एक एग्जाम्पल के तौर से इस कॉन्सेप्ट को समझते हैं। मान लीजिए आपको 54 इंच का डीसी फैन और 54 इंच के एसी फैन को कंपेयर करना है। इन दोनों अप्लायंसेस के पावर कंजम्पशन कैलकुलेट करने के लिए एक सिंपल फॉर्मूला है, P इज इक्वल टू V इंटू I। अब अगर हम डीसी फैन की पावर कंजम्पशन कैलकुलेट करना चाहते हैं, तो हम V की वैल्यू फॉर्मूला में 12 वोल्ट रखेंगे, क्योंकि बैटरी से हमें 12 वोल्ट डीसी मिल रहा है और डीसी फैन करीब 2.08 एम्पीयर करंट कंज्यूम करता है। तो फॉर्मूला के अनुसार पावर इज इक्वल टू 12 इंटू 2.08 इज इक्वल टू 25 वॉट। अब अगर हम एसी फैन की पावर कंजम्पशन कैलकुलेट करना चाहते हैं, तो हम वी की वैल्यू फॉर्मूला में 220 वोल्ट रखेंगे, क्योंकि मेन से हमारे घर पे 220 वोल्ट की सप्लाई आती है और एसी फैन करीब 0.36 एम्पीयर मेन से कंज्यूम करता है। तो फॉर्मूला के अनुसार पावर इज इक्वल टू 220 इंटू 0.36 इज इक्वल टू 80 वॉट। इस एग्जाम्पल से आप देख सकते हैं कि एक 54 इंच का डीसी फैन 25 वॉट पावर कंज्यूम करता है, वहीं एक 54 इंच का एसी फैन करीब 80 वॉट पावर कंज्यूम करता है, जिससे हमें ये पता चलता है कि डीसी अप्लायंसेस यूज करने से लगभग 70% पावर की सेविंग्स होती है। और क्योंकि कम पावर कंजम्पशन हो रहा है, तो जाहिर है कि आपका बैकअप टाइम भी बढ़ जाएगा। 70% कम पावर कंजम्पशन की वजह से हमें बैटरी से 3 गुना ज्यादा बैकअप मिलता है, जिससे आप अनुमान लगा सकते हैं कि आपके मंथली इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बिल पे कितना फर्क।
इट्स वेरी सिंपल इन नेचर। वी हैव अ सिंटेक्स टैंक 500 लीटर्स एंड 500 लीटर्स। इन द फर्स्ट हाउस दे यूज वाटर लाइक एनीथिंग, इन द सेकंड हाउस दे यूज जुडिशियसली। सो द टाइम टेकन टू एम्प्टी इन द टैंक इज वेरी लेस इन द फर्स्ट टैंक।
अब हम डीसी सप्लाई से डीसी अप्लायंसेस रन करने से होने वाले एक और फायदे को समझेंगे। मान लीजिए आपके घर में एक नॉर्मल इन्वर्टर है, जो कि मेन से आने वाले एसी सप्लाई को डीसी में कन्वर्ट करके बैटरीज को चार्ज करता है, और उसके बाद बैटरी में सो डीसी सप्लाई को फिर एसी में कन्वर्ट करके लोड रन करता है। इस एसी टू डीसी और डीसी टू एसी कन्वर्जन में कुछ एनर्जी लॉस हो जाता है, क्योंकि जब भी एक एनर्जी फॉर्म दूसरे एनर्जी फॉर्म में कन्वर्ट किया जाता है, तो हीट या स्विचिंग लॉसेस के फॉर्म में कुछ एनर्जी लॉस हो जाते हैं, जिससे आपके इन्वर्टर से कनेक्टेड लोड एक्स्ट्रा पावर कंज्यूम करता है। लेकिन एक डीसी सिस्टम में ये लॉसेस नहीं होते, क्योंकि इस सिस्टम में किसी भी फॉर्म का एनर्जी कन्वर्जन, यानी एसी टू डीसी या डीसी टू एसी नहीं होता। ये सिस्टम डीसी पावर से ही बैटरीज को चार्ज करता है और डीसी पावर से ही लोड रन करता है, जिससे डीसी सिस्टम एक साधारण इन्वर्टर से काफी एफिशिएंट बन जाता है। डीसी पावर से होने वाले फायदे तो आप समझ ही गए होंगे। अब हम एक सोलर डीसी सिस्टम कैसे काम करता है, ये समझेंगे। डीसी सिस्टम घर में इंस्टॉल करने के लिए आपको सोलर पैनल्स, बैटरीज और डीसी लोड की जरूरत पड़ेगी। डीसी सिस्टम सोलर पैनल से आने वाले डीसी पावर से इंटेलिजेंटली बैटरीज को चार्ज करता है और डीसी लोड रन करता है। ये डीसी सिस्टम 800 VA 12 वोल्ट में अवेलेबल है। इस सिस्टम के साथ आप घर में लगे 3 DC फैन, 1 DC LED TV और 3-4 DC LED लाइट्स बड़ी आसानी से चला सकते हैं। जैसा हमने पहले भी बताया था, ये सारे अप्लायंसेस डीसी हैं, इसलिए इनकी पावर कंजम्पशन एसी अप्लायंसेस के मुकाबले बहुत ही कम होती है। अगर कभी सोलर से मिलने वाला पावर बैटरी को चार्ज करने के लिए काफी नहीं है, तो आप अपने डीसी सिस्टम से कनेक्टेड बैटरीज को मेन से भी बड़ी आसानी से चार्ज कर सकते हैं। इसके अलावा डीसी सिस्टम के अंदर 2 चार्ज कंट्रोलर्स इनबिल्ट है, 12 वोल्ट 10 एम्पियर का MPPT सोलर चार्ज कंट्रोलर, जो सोलर पैनल से आने वाला अनकंट्रोल्ड पावर को कंट्रोल करके आपके बैटरीज को एफिशिएंटली चार्ज करता है, और दूसरा है 12 वोल्ट 10 एम्पियर का ग्रिड चार्जर, जो मेन सप्लाई से बैटरीज चार्ज करता है। लेकिन मेन्स की कनेक्टिविटी सिस्टम के साथ तभी होती है जब सिस्टम से कनेक्टेड बैटरी और सोलर पैनल से आने वाला करंट एक प्रीसेट लिमिट से नीचे चली जाए। इस फीचर की वजह से मेन सप्लाई मिनिमम यूटिलाइज होती है और मैक्सिमम सेविंग्स होते हैं। इस कॉन्सेप्ट को थोड़े डिटेल में समझते हैं। मान लीजिए आपने डीसी सिस्टम के साथ 12 वोल्ट 120 एएच की बैटरी और 120 वाट के सोलर पैनल्स कनेक्ट किए हुए हैं। इस 12 वोल्ट बैटरी की बूस्ट वोल्टेज 14.4 वोल्ट है, यानी कि 14.4 वोल्ट पे बैटरी फुल्ली चार्ज हो जाती है। 120 एएच की बैटरी को चार्ज होने के लिए करीब 10 एम्पीयर करंट की जरूरत पड़ेगी। डीसी सिस्टम बैटरी को चार्ज करने के लिए पूरे 10 एम्पीयर सोलर से लेता है, लेकिन अगर सोलर से मिलने वाला करंट 4 एम्पीयर या उससे नीचे चली जाए और बैटरी की वोल्टेज 12.5 वोल्ट से नीचे डिस्चार्ज हो जाए, तो डीसी सिस्टम में मेंस की कनेक्टिविटी हो जाएगी और बैटरीज मेन से चार्ज होगी, और जैसे ही सोलर पावर फिर अवेलेबल हो जाएगी तो डीसी सिस्टम बैटरीज को सोलर से चार्ज करेगी। अब हम डीसी सिस्टम के फ्रंट पैनल को समझेंगे। डीसी सिस्टम के फ्रंट पैनल पे एक LCD डिस्प्ले और उसके नीचे 3 LED इंडिकेशन लाइट्स प्रोवाइडेड हैं। LCD डिस्प्ले पे आप सिस्टम के अलग अलग पैरामीटर्स जैसे कि रुपीज सेविंग्स, बैटरी वोल्टेज, सोलर वोल्टेज और करंट, सोलर चार्ज कंट्रोलर ऑन और ऑफ, ग्रिड चार्जर ऑन और ऑफ, MPPT इक्वलाइजेशन ऑन जैसे मैसेजेस देख सकते हैं। इसके अलावा LCD डिस्प्ले के नीचे दी गई LED इंडिकेशन लाइट्स अलग अलग कंडीशंस में ग्लो होती है। पहला इंडिकेशन है जब मेन्स से बैटरी चार्ज हो रही है, तो मेन्स चार्जिंग ऑन LED ग्रीन कलर में ग्लो करेगा, और उसके बाद जब बैटरी सोलर से चार्ज हो रही है तो सोलर चार्जिंग ऑन LED ग्रीन कलर में ब्लिंक करेगी, और जब बैटरी सोलर से फुल्ली चार्ज हो जाए तो सोलर ऑन LED कंटिन्यूसली ग्लो करेगी। जब सिस्टम से कनेक्टेड बैटरी डिस्चार्ज होकर लो कंडीशन में चली जाए तो तीसरा LED रेड कलर में कंटिन्यूसली ग्लो करेगा। इसके अलावा DC सिस्टम में एक मोबाइल चार्जिंग पोर्ट भी प्रोवाइडेड है, जिससे आप USB केबल के थ्रू अपने मोबाइल फोन को सोलर पावर से चार्ज कर सकते हैं। अब हम DC सिस्टम में प्रोवाइडेड कुछ इम्पोर्टेंट प्रोटेक्शन फीचर्स को समझेंगे। DC सिस्टम में प्रोटेक्शन के लिए 2 फ्यूज प्रोवाइडेड है, AC फ्यूज और DC फ्यूज। पहले हम AC फ्यूज को समझेंगे। DC सिस्टम में 6.5 एम्पीयर का AC फ्यूज सिस्टम के साइड पैनल पे प्रोवाइडेड है। अगर मेन से आने वाला इनपुट करंट
A fuse is a device which is used to safeguard the rest of the system. You know very well in our inverters we have a fuse which is shown on the monitor, and then this is made up of a glass tube, and inside there will be a small diameter silver thread will be there, and suppose if the flow of current is more, what will happen, this thread will melt away and then it will say the fuse has gone, it is short circuit is over, so that the additional flow of current will not enter the other side of the system. So a fuse is a very important concept which will be safeguarding our system. So ensure that whenever the fuses are gone, you try to replace with the standard fuse, because the cost of the fuse is 10 rupees only, but you are supposed to use it because you are going to safeguard some thousands of rupees electrical appliances in your house. That is very much, that is important.
0.5 ampere से ज्यादा बढ़ जाए तो AC फ्यूज ब्लो हो जाता है और आपके सिस्टम को प्रोटेक्टेड रखता है। सिस्टम के दूसरे साइड पैनल पे 30 एम्पियर का DC फ्यूज प्रोवाइडेड है। अगर किसी कारण DC सिस्टम के साथ बैटरी के रिवर्स कनेक्शंस हो जाते हैं तो डीसी फ्यूज ब्लो हो जाएगा और आपके सिस्टम को प्रोटेक्टेड रखेगा।
दिस इज द ग्रेटेस्ट डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ डीसी पावर। हाउ शुड वी अंडरस्टैंड दिस? इन आवर हाउस वी आर हैविंग ए टू पिन प्लग इज देयर। सो यू टेक योर हेयर ड्रायर, whether you insert it from left hand side to right hand side, right hand like inverted hand, anything, it will go, no problem. But in case of a battery, if you see, when you are putting your batteries in a calculator or something else, they will be giving specifically positive and negative charge, negative thing. So you should give connections only on that one. If you try to give in a reverse direction, then there is a chances of explosions also there. Especially this is very important in case of a the cell phones. So if the cell phone batteries are not installed properly, or if the polarities are different, then of course explosion will take place. So DC, we have this problem of polarity. Problem of polarity is not there for the AC. So this is about the thing, and now let's see how many types of solar panels are available. I said that solar panels are of three types basically. First one is monocrystalline, second one is polycrystalline, third one is amorphous. Monocrystalline is the most important efficient solar panel. So if you are using that, its size is small, its cost is low. You go for polycrystalline, efficiency is little bit less, so hence the cost is also less, but the cross-section area, the surface area which to entrap the power, the sunlight will be increasing. And the cheapest one is amorphous. Its efficiency is very less. So hence, if you have a larger area, you can go for amorphous. But everything is perfectly designed to convert solar energy to the electrical energy. Only thing is, difference is what? Your cost factor and your space. Based on that, you are going to select the solar panel. So it is an important question for you. Which type of solar panel you are going to use? So for that, you should give the answer first. Sir, we have lot of area, we don't have much finance, then you go for MR. Sir, we have small area, our finances are very high, then you go for monocrystalline. So in between comes the concept of polycrystalline. Okay. No problem, audio is not there, good thing. Monocrystalline, polycrystalline, half cut, amorphous. The middle one is the new one. Split type. Monocrystalline. For what? This is YouTube video. Mono. No panel. The cost has increased because of high energy things. Offset panel, the latest one. Individual photovoltaic cell is called as a cell. The back side of the solar panel. Eco-friendly panel. Further high cost. So this is the socket behind it. Now let us see so this is a very important so that is specifications of the solar panel, how to purchase them, and what are the prerequisites. Let us see, just have an introduction of it. First point, which is this, all these things which will be raised on the panel, behind the solar panel there will be a nameplate will be there on which they will write everything. The first one is standard test conditions. You know very well, when we want to purchase a motor vehicle or something else, they will be giving us the mileage consumption. They will say 60 kilometers per liter, but they will put a small asterisk and then say, and at the ball below they will write a small font, they will write only under standard operating conditions. Means what? They will not drive the vehicle in reality in a way in a main road. In a closed compartment on a pulley, they try to drive. The air resistance is not there because they wanted to put highlight 30 kilometers per hour, 40 kilometers per hour, 50, 60, 70, 80. Yeah, as they increase the number of kilometers, the consumer will be attracted to it. Or a 1 liter petrol, it can go for 100 kilometers, beautiful vehicle. But when it comes to the reality, it may come only 40 kilometers. The company, when you go to the company fellow and say that what is the difference between 40 and 100, he will say, sir, there is an asterisk is there below, you read it. Then they say, only under standard operating conditions. So what are the conditions which are practiced by the company is not real. So once you purchase it and then when you bring the vehicle here, it may give 10 liters also. Or in some cases there will be 50 kilometers per liter, whatever it is. But the equipment will be tested by any standard procedure method. And there they give a value. And that value will definitely differ with the real value. So what is this actually? Let us see. STC, that is standard test conditions, is a set of a criteria that the solar panel is tested at. We are supposed to test it. What? How we are going to test the solar panel? You are going to keep the solar panel sunlight and then you are going to measure how much amount of voltage you are going to get, how much amount of air you are going to get, how much amount of current you are going to get. And what will be the temperature which it can withstand. This is the facts. Because I said that you can't throw stones on the solar panel. You are supposed to safeguard of it, you are supposed to clean it, keep it clean. But only thing is temperature. Suppose if you are going to keep a solar panel in Rajasthan, the operating temperatures are very high. Suppose if you are going to keep a solar panel in Ooty, the solar panel temperature is exposed to this low temperature. But it should be useful at a constant temperature. It should be live, it should be functioning, it should be tested at a constant temperature. Since the voltage and the current change based on the temperature and intensity of light among the other criteria, yes, very good. In the morning you keep a solar panel, morning where the sunlight is present far away. So the distance between your solar panel and your sunlight is very far. But by the time it comes to afternoon, what will happen? It perfectly is there on your top, perpendicular it strikes and you get maximum amount of radiations. So your solar panel should be able to withstand this kind of variations. The intensity of sunlight which is falling on it, it should resist and accordingly it should generate the electrons. That is also important. All solar panels are tested to the same standard condition. This includes the cells temperatures at 25 degrees centigrade. So at 25 degrees centigrade, first the test will be conducted and the light intensity of 1000 watts per square meter, that is how much amount of light we are going to tolerate is per square meter, it is 1000 watts. And which is basically the sun at the noon. So remember, these conditions are at the noon. Means what? If your solar panel is withstanding the conditions in the afternoon, then of course, definitely it will withstand in the morning and withstand in the evening because sun is present on your top in the afternoon, in the noon, and the temperature is maximum. So when your solar panel is passing that, then definitely it will pass any type of condition. In which basically the sun is at the noon and the atmospheric density is 1.5 kg per meter cube, that is the air density, etc. And the sun's angle directly perpendicular to the solar panel at 500 feet above the sea level. These are the conditions. At this point, whatever the voltage is generated, current is generated, that is stated under STC conditions, standard test conditions. Then comes the question of normality. So normally what will happen, the standard test conditions, normal test conditions are varying because you know very well, I purchased a vehicle which is tested that it is 60 kilometers per hour, but on road it is giving only 35. So nobody can do anything. Nobody can do anything. So what is this? How much amount of decrease will be there that is given in this NOCT, that is normal operating cell temperature, which will be kept at 20 degrees centigrade maximum. NOCT takes a more realistic view of actual real world conditions because the temperature will be maximum at that time. But sometimes it will be very less. Suppose on a rainy day, what will happen? The temperature may fall down. When the temperature falls, what will happen? There is the material may be damaged. So it has to withstand this kind of variations. And they fix that an average temperature of 20 is sufficient for this. And in the morning, in the afternoon, the sunlight will be maximum. But in the evening, it will be only less. Some lesser value, so it should be able to withstand it. So it's not say that no, I cannot function when these radiations are very less. It has to work. That is important. NOCT takes a more realistic view of actual real world conditions and gives you the power ratings that you likely actually see from your solar system. Instead of 1000 watts per square meter, it uses 800 watts per square meter, which is closer to the most sunny days as well. So you should be in a position to generate electricity. So even 80 years also, so means what? There should be lower limit should be there, there should be upper limit should be there. Then open circuit voltage, what is this? VOC means what? I hope, sorry, this page little bit technical knowledge is required, little bit, but don't worry. But I put a small question to you. When you purchase a battery Duracell, what you will see? How many batteries you are supposed to purchase is very important, because you know your torchlight, it may carry 4 batteries. Some parts are 2 batteries. Some batteries, say for example, your telephone, television remote, TV remote, 2 batteries, 1.5 volts. And some gadgets are there where they use different types of sizes of batteries. So remember, in the market, there are 3 types of Duracell batteries are available. But remember, all are rated at 1.5 volts. All are rated at 1.5 volts. Remember, no doubt about it. But the sizes are different. One is small, one is pencil size, one is the bigger. So whatever is written on that, that is called as the open circuit voltage, or similarly open circuit current. Open circuit voltage is how many volts the solar panel output with no load on it. We are not putting any load on it, so we are not connecting anything on it. Just we are taking a testing sample, we are taking testing equipment, like ammeter, voltmeter, wattmeter, whatever is it, and then you are inserting in it, and then you are measuring what is the voltage. Whatever the voltage which you are going to measure by inserting your wattmeter, your ammeter, anything else in between positive and negative terminals, whatever reading you are going to see, it is called as open circuit voltage. That is the maximum voltage which can be generated by your solar panel. Remember, and the particular time, that is, time is important, because morning it will be less, afternoon it is maximum, in the evening it will be less, and in the night time it is almost zero. Then short circuit current, the same thing, insert the ammeter and measure the current. This is the maximum. Okay, so once you know the maximum, you can find out what will be the maximum power obtained from it. You know, just now we have seen one formula, maximum power is equal to voltage into current. Okay, so if you multiply these two things, what will happen? You will be getting the maximum power which you are going to get it from the solar panel. Remember this. So now remember, if your requirement is 10 watts, then solar panel which you will purchase, maximum 10 watts, no, you will be purchasing little bit higher, because maximum is 10 watts. When you get the maximum, in the afternoon you get the maximum. So this will become decreasing. So in the evening, what will happen, it will give you 6. So when your requirement is 10 watts, if the voltage given is 6 watts, then it cannot drive. So hence what you should do, you should try to have 2 or more or little bit higher capacity. For this purpose, you are going to use this. Concept is similar. You are storing water for 24 hours. Tomorrow morning, again, the watchman will fill that tank. Again, sustainability is there, that's the meaning of it. And this is very important, that is, how many volts, 12 volts, 20 volts, 24 volts. Number of cells means what? The small blue color you have seen, the squares, that is called as a cell. 36, 60 and 72 are available in the market. And now, what is the voltage? 22 volts, 38 and 40. So number of cells are increasing, so number of voltage will also increase. Number of power is also in maximum power in volt ampere. This is also increasing. So each cell. So remember, this is tabular column is very important for you, and based on this you will go for the designing of your solar power plant.